Riders and neighbors along the coast are getting ready for Tropical Storm Karen's landfall. Reporter Travers Macko live for us from Pascagoula with more out there. How are the winds out there, Travers?
Well, they're not that bad, Camille. Take a look. They were much worse yesterday, if you will, and I know it's a cliche. It's kind of the calm before the storm, as Margaret and Quaylen said. We could see a massive storm surge here in Jackson County. We're on the beach in Pascagoula. Now, all up and down the coast, people are pulling down flags, boarding up their homes, doing the little things it takes. They're battle-tested here along the Mississippi Gulf Coast when it comes to dealing with tropical storms and hurricanes. No mandatory evacuations just yet. That could change in the next couple of hours as this storm does get closer to shore. We caught up with the head of MEMA, the Mississippi Emergency Management Agency. Here's what he tells us about Karen.
Felt from the very beginning, Jackson County, Pascagoula area was going to get significant storm surge, could have more of an impact. The citizens on the coast are not the ones I'm worried about. They know what to do. We've got thousands of citizens down here for cruising the coast, which starts Sunday afternoon. So we've just cautioned them not to put up tents and things until this storm passed. So I think we could still be impacted by this storm.
We should point out they do have a big festival this weekend. That is still on. Also, all of the hotels along the coast and casinos remain open for now. Obviously, gaming officials waiting and watching, but they don't expect to shut down any of those hotels or casinos since this storm, as Margaret and Quaylen said, has now been downgraded. Reporting on your side on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, I'm Travers Macko, WDSU News.